Hello friends and welcome back to Java Tutorial for Beginners. In the last video, we saw what classes and objects are, and today I'm going to introduce you to methods. Now, what is a method? Very simply put, a method is a set of statements in your Java program grouped together by a name to perform some operation of the program. But why do we actually need to group these statements together and give them a name? Why can't we just use the statements as such in our Java program? Let's take a look at why do we need to do that and then move on to what syntax is used to create a method in Java. So the very first reason we use method is for reusable code. If you need to do the same thing multiple times, instead of copying pasting those 10-15 lines of code again and again in your program, you better write a method and call it each time. The second reason is to parameterize the code. Add different parameters set to the method to change the way the method works depending on the number of parameters provided. The third reason why we use methods is because it helps achieve top-down programming. Now, this is a very useful style of programming. You solve a big problem by breaking it down into smaller ones. So you write a method that is main to solve the bigger problem by calling smaller methods into your main method. The fourth reason is to create conceptual units. Create methods to do something that is one action or part of the problem. This makes programming further easy and also makes your program more readable. And the fifth and final reason why you should use methods in your programming is to simplify your code. When you group logical part of a program into a method, it reduces complexity by hiding the irrelevant details and the method data from the rest of the program. So now that we know why we need to use methods, let's take a look at a basic method syntax in Java. Public static int method name followed by the parameters, and then inside the braces you give a set of statements that make the method body. Now public static, as you know, are the access modifiers. So they define the access type of the method and these are optional. Int or any other return type that you provide gives the program the knowledge of what value can be returned from this method back to the calling method. The method name should be relevant to what your program is doing. Try to keep your method names relevant to what actually you are doing inside the method so that it is easier for you to get back to the program and understand what it's doing. And finally, the parameters, int A and int B. Now, the list of parameters can be as much as you want or cannot be at all. There could be function that does not take any parameter at all. All right. Now, how do you call this method from your program? There are two ways to go about it, depending on whether the method returns a value or not. When it doesn't return a value, you can directly call the method like a statement. Say, for example, your system.out.println method that prints something on the screen. And when your method returns a value, you can call it like this. So the result stores the value returned by the method sum. So that is why we need methods in our program. To make the program more simple, more readable, more understandable, broken up into chunks of code that is easier to understand and comprehend. Now, in the next video, I'll show you a quick program that will make use of some such multiple short methods to do one big task. And the task would be fairly simple, your everyday program, but you'll see how you break your program, how you apply this top-down programming approach in any problem that you solve and use methods in action. I'll see you in the next video, guys. Bye-bye.